Hey y'all, welcome to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Samantha Leanne and I talk about books. Today we're here with another horror recommendations video. I am really loving the process of doing this. My first one was Haunted House Recommendations. I will link that up above if you are interested in watching that if you haven't seen it yet. This is a series that I plan to continue as I, you know, continue to read more and more horror. These first couple of videos, you guys are gonna notice that a lot of my recommendations are probably some more basic, well-known titles for these particular subgenres, but they're just the titles that I'm currently most familiar with. Obviously, if you have any recommendations, please comment down below. I would love to know what they are because I am always adding to these lists. Another thing that I did after my last video was I started thinking about it, and not only do I enjoy horror books, but I also really enjoy horror films. So I asked you guys in a poll on the community page whether or not you would like for me to include certain movie recommendations for these subgenres of horror. The general consensus was 5 books and 5 films. I'm going to actually be doing 5 books and 3 films. I realized that there are a lot of horror films that I still haven't seen. However, there were a lot of you guys that were like, yeah, no, please don't talk about movies, just talk about books. So obviously we're gonna start this off with just the books, and then at the end, I'll talk about the movies. So for those of you that don't care about the movies, you can just click off at that point, okay? Today's episode, if you didn't read the title or see the thumbnail, is about possessions. I've read a couple really good possession stories lately. You guys probably saw them in a wrap-up not that long ago. And then there's a couple more like obvious suggestions. So we're talking about possessions today. Like why do I like possession stories? I think one of the reasons for me personally that possessions are like compelling to me and why I enjoy reading about them and why I find them scary is because I am a person who very much has to be in control of things, right? And so the idea of something creeping into your consciousness and kicking you out and you taking a back seat to your everyday life and having to watch yourself, you know, like perform actions or doing things that you wouldn't normally do, you know, forget the fact that it's the devil, but just like not being in control of yourself, you know, is the thing that scares me the most. I'm sure that there are some people that would love to take a backseat to their life and have somebody else like take the reins. I am not one of those people. I will never be one of those people, but that's one of the reasons that I find possession stories so compelling. I'm really interested to see what you guys think about that as well. Is there a particular reason that you enjoy possession stories? You know, books, film, whatever the case may be. Comment down below and let me know what that is. I'd really love to hear. But yeah, let's just go ahead and talk about what books I have to recommend. So I feel I would be a little bit remiss to not include The Exorcist, both the book and the film, on this list. It's probably one of the most well-known possession stories ever. I read the book actually before I saw the film the first time, and I really, really enjoyed the book. If for some reason you've seen the film and haven't read the book, I recommend reading it. It's a pretty true adaptation, honestly, but I think the way that it's written is very excellent. I haven't read any of the subsequent sequels, like Legion, I think is the sequel. I've heard it's pretty decent. Maybe one day I'll get to it, but anyway, I'm not gonna go into what that's about because like y'all already know, let's be real. So the first possession story that I'm going to recommend is one of my favorite books from the month of April, and that is Come Closer by Sarah Grand. This is actually a novella and I read it in 2 sittings. You have your character Amanda. She is married. She lives in this really awesome apartment with her husband. You know, they have fights every so often, but let's be real, what couple doesn't, right? And she's in a really good place in her job. Like her life is just really good. And then she starts hearing this like tapping in her apartment one day and can't figure out what it's from. After she starts hearing this tapping, things about her personality begin to change. Things in her life slowly begin to devolve, and suddenly she doesn't recognize herself. Suddenly she's not sure who she is anymore. And she's left trying to figure out, is she possessed or is there something else going on? You can't really say too much more other than that in regards to the plot. One of the things that I really appreciate about this particular story is the ambiguity that the author kind of gives you. Is this a possession story or is this a mental illness story? Like what exactly is going on here? And you're kind of left for yourself to decide. But the way that it was written was really good. It was really compelling. Like I said, I read it in 2 sittings in the same day. I couldn't put it down. Definitely one of my favorite, not just possession stories, but probably one of my favorite horror novellas recently. So 100% recommend that one. Another one that I read very recently is Seed by Anya Allborn. This is about a family of four. You have a younger and an older daughter. One night while they are driving, the family gets into a car accident after something runs out in the road in front of them. And the younger child hits their head and she begins to act very strangely. But the problem being is that nobody else except for the younger daughter and the father saw something run out into the road. And after the child starts acting strangely, you're trying to figure out, is this some sort of head trauma or is there something else going on with this child? And you slowly also begin to learn more about the father and more about his childhood and maybe why it's not a head injury that's going on with this kid. The setting is in Louisiana and Anya Allborn writes her setting so well. It's just very appropriate where this is taking place, right? The family dynamic in this is also really well written. I sometimes find family dynamics in certain books to be they don't feel real to me, but this one felt very real. Not being a mother, I can't really speak to that aspect of it because it does go back and forth between the perspective of the mother and the father and what is really going on in each of their heads and the worry that they're feeling over their daughter. She did a really good job on that. Parts of this are pretty gruesome and I'm here to tell y'all the ending is just A+ shit. It is A+. I loved it. Absolutely loved it. That is a contender for my favorite Anya Allborn story for sure. The next book I'm going to talk about is Head Full of Ghosts by Paul Tremblay. This is the story of another family unit and they have this house and they're kind of coming up on hard times. You have a younger daughter and an older daughter. The parents are sort of becoming estranged and the family themselves, the family unit is really starting to break down. And money is an issue, and all of a sudden the older daughter starts acting really weird. The dynamic between the older and younger daughter was so authentic to me. I loved it because it really did feel like they were siblings. Sometimes with sibling relationships, again, it feels forced. This felt like parts of it felt like me and my sibling whenever I was younger. And so that really spoke to me. The older daughter starts acting very strangely and everybody starts to think that this child is possessed. Subsequently, a film crew is invited to film the daughter and, to help them get money and that sort of thing. The book is very meta in that, it directly references, The Exorcist and the fact that it could be potentially a ripoff of The Exorcist and things like that. I did really enjoy that aspect of it, but the emotion that Paul Tremblay brings into this book and again, those familial relationships, I think really add another layer to the book as a whole. So it is a possession story, but it's a lot more than that. And so, I love books with layers. That's one of my favorite things about horror is layering like this. So yeah, I definitely really enjoyed this and I'll 100% recommend it all the time for a possession story and just in general. Next book I'm going to talk about is My Best Friend's Exorcism by Grady Hendrix. I loved this book because it is an ode to 80s horror movies, right? It takes place in the 80s in Charleston, South Carolina, which I'm from South Carolina, so I'm a little bit biased there. However, it follows the story of two girls. One of them is rich, one of them is not. And one of them becomes possessed. And so the other friend has to figure out, how to exorcise this demon from her friend, right? The relationship between the two teenage girls is written, it was fun. There were aspects of it. The writing itself is fun. There's a comedic element to the writing at points, which I think is a good break for some of the creepier parts of the book. But overall, it's just, I fucking loved it. I thought it was really great. It's another book that I'm forever recommending. So, and the last book that I'm going to talk about, and this one's kind of a gimme, but that's Christine by Stephen King. I was going to really try not to include Stephen King on any of these lists, but I really feel like this is a really good possession story. This one was also made into a film, which I have also never seen. But for those of you that are not familiar with the story, you have Dennis and Arnie. They grew up together. One of them is kind of a jock. The other one is kind of a nerd, but they grew up together. They're very close. They've remained very close through high school. And one day they're driving down the road and Arnie sees this Plymouth Fury that he just absolutely falls in love with and he has to have this car. And so he buys this car. But turns out the car is a little bit more than a car. I really liked this book. I don't think that it cracks my top 10 of Stephen King, but it's definitely up there. Like, it's in the upper half for sure. I do feel like it can be a little bit long, and I haven't done my full King Chronicles episode for this particular book just yet. For the time being, I will go ahead and link up above the King Chronicles playlist. So if maybe you're watching this later, I may have uploaded it by then. The dynamic between Arnie and Dennis is just done very well. Again, like that friend dynamic, as well as like the creepier elements, are also really well done. So while it's a gimme, I still chose to include it on the list. So those are the books that I have to recommend for Possessions. I have a couple films that I want to talk about as well. So Possession films, obviously we already discussed The Exorcist. Christine obviously is another one that I have mentioned, but there's a couple that I haven't. I feel like when it comes to horror films, there's a million, like The Exorcism, The Last Exorcism. But one of my favorite exorcism movies is The Exorcism of Emily Rose. And I think one of the reasons that I enjoyed that one as much as I have is because the actress who played Emily Rose, her facial expressions, and she acted the shit out of that movie, I'm here to tell you. I remember when that film came out, and I think I was sick at home and was laying on the couch watching it. Like, I remember seeing that movie for the first time. And I've seen it a couple of times since then. You know, realistically, it is your standard exorcism movie. Like, it really is. There's nothing groundbreaking about the content. I think, to me, one of the reasons that I love it is because, number one, it's nostalgic. Like, I remember that being one of the first, like, real exorcism movies that I saw. In addition to the fact, like, the acting to me also just brings it to a whole other level. So that's one that I really love. Also, let's talk about The Evil Dead. The Evil Dead is by far one of my favorite horror franchises ever. Okay. Evil Dead, Evil Dead 2, Army of Darkness, and the remake that was done in 2013, I think it was. So good. So good. When talking about the original, you have Ash and his group of friends that go up into the woods to a cabin to get away. While they are there, they find a book, and unfortunately they read from the book and they release a presence that possesses Ash's girlfriend and possesses, you know, Ash's hand at one point and things of that nature. I would say that the original first one is, if you're going to talk about like the actual horror factor, the original Evil Dead is by far the most horror heavy of the three. When you get into Evil Dead 2, it becomes a little bit more of like a horror comedy. When you get to Army of Darkness, it's almost entirely a comedy, but I still love it. Like, I will forever love that movie. When you get to the remake that was done in 2013, they reimagined it, you know, for a more modern era, and y'all, that movie is gross. That film has some of the grossest scenes I have ever seen in a film. Things that I have a hard time watching. I've rewatched it a couple times. We went and saw it in theaters, and there were parts in theater whenever I had to turn away, and to this day, there are parts of it that I still can't look at. Like, it's that horrific and that gruesome. So I will definitely say, if you were gonna watch the remake, like, it's fucking gross, like, prepare yourself, but it is also like really good. Visually, it's stunning, you know, and again, just the caliber of like the practical effects and stuff is also really good. And another movie that I've seen fairly recently that has quickly become one of my absolute favorites is Hereditary. This is about a family who has suffered the loss of a grandmother who was very overbearing at points. So while in a lot of senses this film is about grief, there's a lot more going on in this film than really meets the eye. I'm not going to tell you too much about the actual plot because I feel like you need to like go in as blind as you can, because I went in thinking that this film was going to be about one thing, and it completely went in a direction that I wasn't expecting it to go. But the acting in this film is like first rate, A+. Toni Collette deserved an award for that performance. I will argue with you until I am blue in the face. She was absolutely phenomenal. Again, one of the things that I love about horror is not only does it explore fear, but it also explores so many different emotions. And this film really talked about grief in a lot of different ways, and I loved that. Visually, it was done very well. Like, the cinematography was really great. But again, just the performances from the actors were absolutely phenomenal. In addition to, very rarely do movies make me yell out loud. I screamed while I was watching this film. Screamed, because there is a thing that happens that just absolutely caught me off guard. And I was like, oh my God, what did I just see? The event itself wasn't even like scary per se. It was just so shocking that I screamed, and that doesn't happen very often. And like, I absolutely loved it. I thought it was absolutely fantastic. If you haven't watched it, you really need to. So yes, those are my favorite possession books and my favorite possession films. Have you read these books or seen these movies? Comment down below and let me know. And if you guys have any suggestions for any particular books or films in this category, definitely comment down below and let me know. I have lists going for all kinds of different subgenres for this particular series. And just because I do like possessions once, as I read more books and see more movies that go with this particular subgenre, you know, we'll do like a part two or a part two haunted houses or whatever the case may be. But I have possessions, I have just regular ghost stories, haunted houses, creepy kids or kids in horror, true crime as well. It's not necessarily horror, but I do really enjoy true crime, so I do want to put some recs out there for that. Fairy tale or folk horror, psychological horror, supernatural, creature features, and vampires. So I've got tons of content coming up for this series. I'm really excited to do it. If you decide to take any of these suggestions or read or watch any of these things for the first time and you love them, come back here and comment and let me know. Or you can get at me on Twitter, Goodreads, or Instagram. All of my social media links can be found in the down bar below. If this is your first time here, hi, hello, and welcome. This is a series that I'm going to be doing pretty regularly, hopefully. Horror recommendations, different subgenres of horror. If you are interested, I will be linking a playlist up above so you can see what other videos I have done in this particular series. If you like what you see and you want to see more, you can click thumbs up, you can hit the subscribe button, you can click the bell notification to be notified whenever I upload videos. But yeah, that's all I have for you guys today. So thank you guys so much for joining me today. Thank you for watching, and I will see you all next time. Bye.